Now see it page number 100. 1 square equal to 1. So root 1 is equal to 1. Because we are talking only positive numbers. 2 square equal to 4. So square root of 4 is 2. Same way. 10 square is equal to 100. So square root of 100 is 10. Now finding square root through the repeated subtraction. Clear? Now what we will do? We know that the sum of first n odd natural numbers is n square. For example, if we are taking 1 plus 3, 2 odd natural numbers, answer we will get 4. And 4 is square of 2. Because 1 plus 3, there are 2 terms, so 2 square. N odd numbers. I am writing here, you can see. Suppose that I am writing 1 plus 3 plus 5. How many terms are there? 1, 2, 3. So it will be square of 3. Because the sum of n natural number is equal to n square. So sum of n terms is equal to n square. That is, even a square number can be expressed as a sum of successive odd natural numbers starting from 1. Okay. Consider we want to calculate the square root of 81. So successive odd natural number we will subtract. In my previous video also we have done this. 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, then 9, then 11. In which term, in which step, we are getting remainder is a 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So square root of 81 will be 9. Clear? Now, if we want to calculate the square root of larger number. So 7 to 9 minus 1, then 3, then 5, then 7. Here is only in the 81. 9 steps are there. So in the 729, so many steps will be there. So that method is, this method is time consuming method and lengthy method. Okay. So we generally avoid this method. Now see here, by repeated subtraction of odd natural number starting from 1, find whether the following numbers are perfect square or not. If the number is perfect square, then find its square root. Only first and fifth I will explain you, third you will solve yourself only in the rough notebook. Okay.